Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. Had a pretty good run last time with Blue Baby, but strangely, we are still bereft of the parasite, which is crazy because I keep getting these Steam messages from people saying, dude, I got the parasite like 2 hours in. Well, wish you were here. Let's play as Isaac again. It's been a while since we had the D6 out, and I'm feeling like we could use some kind of, like, electrical boost to jumpstart our play here. Now, jumpstart our luck, really. Our play has been pretty good. One thing worth mentioning about that last video is that I did actually, finally, get the Spelunker Boy achievement, which I've been, you know, colloquially referring to as the Cave Boy achievement throughout the duration of this Let's Play. You know what? I'm gonna stick with the PhD. That's a pretty good item to get right off the bat. Could give us some pills that we can leverage, you know? Range up, tears up. I don't know if there is a damage up pill. Well, I'm gonna use a bomb here because it might be the secret room, and I can get to that other bomb. High-level Isaac play right there. Sadly, I don't have any money with which to use that slot machine, and I want to save this bomb in case I get into, you know, dire straits a little bit later on. I mean, I can get money for nothing, but bombs ain't free. So yeah, I finally got that achievement that I've been working at for such a long time, and I feel like I'm still kind of, I don't want to say on the fence, because that indicates I have some kind of knowledge. I'm making a decision. It's unknown to me whether you get the Golden God achievement just for getting every single item, or if you need to get, you know, close to 100%, because that's the way it was in Super Meat Boy. You didn't have to get exactly 100%, but you didn't have to beat the entire game, but you had to get this in-game counter to 100%. So if it's the same way here, then I think I've gotten a little bit closer to 100% by getting that Caves Boy achievement, and probably increased the chances that I'm going to get that Golden God achievement. And hey, I still haven't taken any damage here on the Basement Part 1. Could we possibly have another beautiful run like the one we had last time? We're gonna be fighting a champion Monstro here. What makes him a champion? I'm not so sure. It looks like maybe he's unable to jump, which would, I don't know. In terms of Monstro, that's kind of a crapshoot. I mean, this attack is actually pretty effective for him, because it's kind of difficult to tell where that shower of blood tears is gonna fall. On the other hand, makes him pretty goddamn predictable. I just gotta kinda shoot him into the corner here, and continue doing our quarter circle strafe here. We'll call it the Hadouken strafe from now on. Oh, whoa, he can actually jump. Maybe that was his tactic, is that he lures you into a false sense of security and then comes at you. Actually, it looks like, I don't know. I'm talking out of my ass. Maybe he just has more hit points. Who knows? But in any case, it's a great item to get right off the bat. Pentagram for increased damage. That's +2 to our damage stat. Not gonna reroll that, and in fact did not reroll anything on the first floor there. Which is fine by me. It's hard to argue about the upgrades that I got. I'm a doctor who's doing incredible damage now. You can call me Dr. Demento. Dr. Octopus. Lots of bad doctors. Dr. Insano. We'll head downwards now. Oh! Put out the fire as soon as you can. We got a half heart that hopefully we'll never be able to use. A couple of headless boarsmen there. And with this guy dying, we do have a key, and a second key, so we can go to the item room. Book of Sin is deserving of a reroll. Hey, the Rosary. 3 Spirit Hearts. Not great, but not bad either. Again, if I manage to keep all those Spirit Hearts, that could possibly be, essentially, a free deal with the devil. But that would involve me not getting hit at all for the rest of this floor, which is probably a little bit unlikely, although I have been playing pretty well recently. Who knows? I'm not going to count my chickens before they hatch. We'll see if this is the secret room. It is not. It used to be a negative for indeed. I could say, indeedent it is. That sounded like a Raffy song or something. Very nearly took some damage here, but the rest of this room should be pretty gosh darn simple. Trying to keep it G-rated. There we go, he's dead. There is our boss room, and we will have our D6 recharged after this room. Where is that secret? Come on, there we go. Where is that secret room? Okay, this room, gotta play it a little bit safe. We'll stand right in the middle here. Just try to fire some shots in diagonally. We only need 2 shots to kill each of these things. So I think we'll be alright. If I could actually hit them, there we go. And then just one of these guys, trapped in his own feces-laden prison. My diction on that, my cadence on that was like I was starting a poem. Trapped in a feces-laden prison. My body is shackled, but my mind runs free. I don't know, I'm making it up as I go along here. Judgment, alright, well, I'll give you my 2 cents. Better it goes to a good cause. That's kind of what I figured was going to happen. And hey, look at that. We have a chance to fight the boss, and if we don't take damage, then we will, you know, get a ceremonial Basement Boy achievement. I mean, I've already gotten it, but hey, it'd be nice to get it again. We're not going to reroll what we get here because it's literally impossible, but we might reroll against the devil. The cool thing about rerolling against the devil is, let's say there's an item that you didn't want that was one heart. If you reroll, you can potentially get a better item in that one heart slot, so you can maybe get a discount on some other items that you would normally overpay for. There we go. Okay, we got him down to this state. Now, Famine is pretty easy to take out. Again, I'm not doing circle strafing anymore. I'm just doing quarter circle strafing. Wow. All right, there's our Ceremonial Basement Boy achievement. That play has really stepped up lately. We got Brimstone. We got Sister Maggie. Well, I don't really want any of those. Let's reroll. We got the Nail and the Book of Belial. You know, both tempting, but let's just head down to the next floor. I will hold on to my spirit hearts and my regular hearts. And we'll cross other bridges as we come to them. Of course, we have this cube of meat by us now, which is good because it means we have a little bit of added defense. It would be nice to pick up a guardian angel so that it's spun a little bit faster around us. But for now, feeling pretty good about my chances. Really, that pentagram is such a good drop to get early on in the game because, you know, again, I mention this seemingly every single fucking video, but having increased damage is pretty much the best guarantee that you can have that you're not going to take so much damage either, because you clear out rooms so much faster. As you can see right here, you know, one of these guys, I don't foresee being too much of a problem. And indeed, he was not. There's the shop and the boss room. Might go with the boss room right now, just so I can reroll, and I know that I have enough space to reroll again. Hey, we were gonna... Well, looks like I won't have to reroll anyway. But on the bright side, we are going to get a second cube of meat here, assuming that we don't die in this fight against Pestilence. Which, you know, has happened in the past, but it's probably rare at this point in my Isaac career. Jesus Christ, dude, stop with the silkworms. You're really making this fight a lot longer than it needs to be. There's like six silkworms on the screen, and then you're gonna fire bombs at me at the same time? Well, on the bright side, at least that takes out silkworms as well. Now, I gotta avoid getting trapped in here. Because it's very easy to get trapped in a situation where, you know, the bombs... You're like in between those rocks, so there's nowhere for you to run unless you want to walk on creep or take a bomb hit right to the fucking face. In any case, Pestilence, very nearly dead, and very nearly caught me for some cheap damage there. Don't know why I'm worried so much about taking damage. I mean, I do already have the achievements for this floor, but hey, I guess I'm just for old time's sake, it'd be nice to get it again. Well, we'll upgrade our Meat Boy to, well, our cube of meat to a Meat Boy, and then proceed onwards here. Of course, we need to get to the item room. Now, remember, I believe that Meat Boy, his damage scales with yours. So, because I have that pentagram, oh, probably gonna take some damage here. Because I have that pentagram upgrade, oh, cube of meat, save me, then he will do a little bit more damage than normal. So it's almost like I got kind of like 1.5 Isaacs right now firing away, which is nothing to sneeze at early on in the game like this. We are only on the third floor. I'm a little bit surprised I didn't get the opportunity to make a deal with the devil back there. I guess maybe I hadn't killed enough enemies to make it... I don't know. I didn't develop the game. Hey, speaking of which, Edmund McMillan left a very interesting tweet on Sunday, and it said, hey guys, if we released a huge Binding of Isaac update, something that would literally... Yeah, let's open this up. Something that would literally, like, double the length of the game, would you pay $2 to $3 for it? If I said, obviously, that I would, but if you feel that you would as well, definitely go tweet him at @EdmundMcMillan, because, you know, a little bit more support, maybe we can get another update for Binding of Isaac. And I mean, $2 to $3, not a whole lot to ask, considering out of this Halloween update, I've gotten like, I don't know, what would you say, maybe another 30 hours of play? Kind of hard to believe. And that one was free, so I'd love to see what he would do with a so-called premium update. So again, actually, you know what, I was going to say don't spam him. Absolutely spam him. I would like to make sure that this happens. You don't have to tell him that Northern Lion sent you or anything like that. Just @ Edmund McMillan. I'm sure that a lot of you can probably spell that yourselves, but if not, Google it. And go check it out, you know? Let's use a bomb here. I placed the bomb in completely the wrong spot, so we will not go for that bomb anymore. Actually, I guess I still probably should. I was getting distracted by my Edmund McMillan rant there, but really, I do hope that upgrade comes out. It wouldn't be until later, sometime in 2012, but still, it would be nice. So we got the secret room, might as well visit upon that right away. Noose, absolutely not worth re-rolling. Now we can fly, so we can actually pick up those bombs that I bunged up back there. And the bomb bag, that's a pretty goddamn okay item to have. I don't want to get rid of that one either. This has been the most useless D6 run I've ever had. So get those three bombs and go explore the last room here. I've got to be careful because I really don't want all of these guys to pop up at once. As if we're watching VH1 in the 90s. Go. Worked out pretty well. Again, still no damage taken here through the caves part 1. Starting to get kind of a big head. Starting to feel like, you know what? Maybe I'm half decent at this game. There's another scent for a little bit of extra validation. And you know, in terms of my build right now, I feel pretty good. Lots of damage, PhD, should I ever find pills. Super Meat Boy circling around me, the bomb bag, the noose so I can fucking fly. Which basically means that all speed upgrades are, well, let's phrase it differently. It's basically, oh, damage! 2 hearts of damage! That was stupid. Basically means I don't have to worry about speed upgrades because I'm already a little bit faster just by virtue of the fact that I'm flying. I believe, anyway. Again, might be the placebo effect, but we will fly over, get this pill. It's gotta be good, right? Speed up, alright. I am a little bit faster. Of course I get that after claiming that I didn't want it at all. Let's re-roll the luck foot. Get the doctor's remote. Not a huge fan of that item either, so we'll be going to a few more rooms here in order to rebuild our D6 charge. Looks like we're coming up to what could potentially be the boss room right here. Now this room has a pretty set order that we could probably deal with it in. But instead, let's deal with it coolly, like that. We'll just fly over the rocks, rather than worrying too much about how we're gonna dodge these human popcorns. And the turrets at the same time. They're actually getting some pretty good potential shots in on me until they walked over that spike. Doing very well for bombs. Still doing great for hearts. We'll put a bomb right here, potentially. Well, we'll take out a single fly. Picked up a bomb and key for our troubles. So again, turning a profit. Very rarely do you not turn a profit on Tinted Rocks. In fact, the only situation I can think of is when you get a golden chest out of a Tinted Rock and you don't have any keys with which to open it, which is a damn shame. It always hurts when that happens. Didn't even notice, but I'm all the way up to 15 cents already. Got a surplus of keys, so let's check out the shop. Crown of Thorns. I haven't seen that item in a while. Let's pick that up. What does it do? Increase damage again? Well, I can't complain about that. I should be doing substantial damage now, and combine that with the ability to fly. Feeling pretty good. New pills? Tears up? Okay. This is what I mean. It's why the PhD is a pretty damn good item. Oh man, these guys are dying really quickly. I like it. Now, D6 is ready, so we'll go back to our item room here and re-roll it. If I could get another 5 cents, I would love to buy that other item, or that other pill from the shop, because I know without fail, it's gonna be good for me. Coming up here into the item room, we'll reroll again, hopefully a passive. Hourglass, still not a very good item to be honest with you. We wanna save our reroll now, we come to you know, the moment of truth. We could save our reroll and use it for whatever the boss gives us, or potentially the Satan deal, because we probably will get a Satan deal on this floor considering how well we're doing. I did take that whole heart of damage on, like, the second room here. Or we could reroll the item from the item room, probably get a spacebar item that I don't even want. But on the other hand, I really like the passives that you get from the boss, usually, so I'd probably reroll the boss items less than anything else. But anyway, I guess we'll cross that bridge when we come to it, as I am wont to say. Doing very well for bombs right now. In fact, well enough that I would love to check for the secret room right here. Sometimes that works, sometimes it doesn't. We've only got a couple of rooms left here. Probably not enough to get 2 charges, sadly. But, it's okay. We'll just get this guy down to the ooze if we can. Oh, there we go. Got very well for me. Yet another scent, but still not enough. I'm gonna reroll the item room and then see if maybe it's possible that I can build another charge somewhere. Let's see what we get on our reroll. Hey, money bag. That's perfect. Well, it's not perfect. It's not the most fantastic item we could possibly have, but on the other hand, it also is a passive, and it gives us some money, and money means we can buy things. It means we can gamble a little bit more. It's a pill. What does it do? Bombs are key. Switched bombs and keys. It's not a huge impact on my game, but it's something, I suppose. Wow. starting to get a lot of drops from every room as a result of that bomb bag and the penny bag. Have enough money now that I can go back to the shop and buy the pill. I feel like I'm talking non-stop in this video. There's a lot of shit going on. Oh, Lord. That was very bad play on my part right there. Whoa. These bombs are far-flung. Anarchist Cookbook. Would love to reroll that. In fact, might come back and reroll that, depending on how this boss fight goes, but we'll see. Even if we miss out on that upgrade, we're doing okay. Better than okay, we're doing fantastic here, considering we're lacking my usual canon of overpowered items, like Brimstone, Book of Revelations, the Pony, etc., etc. What's our pill here? Unknown, that's what I wanted. Bad guess? It's a pretty shitty pill, considering I have the PhD upgrade. Not the secret room, which means the secret room could be in like one of six locations. I'm gonna check this one very quick, and if it's not here, then... Oh, it is there. I don't even need to finish my sentence. And we got a one-up for our trouble. Pretty sizable posse following me right now, and we're all flying. This is the legless group of elves from wherever elves came. And we're gonna add to our posse. Was it Rivendell? Or was that the high school where Archie Andrews went? I think it's Rivendell. Anyway. Nerd alert! We're gonna get a little Chad here. Which might be good, seeing as I've taken a pretty substantial amount of damage on this boss fight. Lost all of my spirit hearts and been hit like six times. Little Chad's pretty quick. I guess this is Big Chad. But anyway, we got a spirit heart for our trouble. There's little Chad, we got so much shit on the screen, my computer's probably gonna be hot enough to cook a fried egg on. Oh, we'll get the Ouija board. Yeah, the Ouija board might actually be valuable in this situation. I almost never buy it. Let's reroll this, see if... Nah, it's a shovel. I almost never buy it. But in this situation, we can fly, so we can position ourselves, like, behind some rocks. Whoa. And then just fire away. Five leapers. Really shitty room to get right at the get-go here. Luckily, I am doing a lot of damage, so I can just kind of fly my way home here. And just random fire should be enough to take them out. Excellent. But I'm running really, really low on health right here. So I've got to be a little bit more cautious than usual. Oh, it's my favorite enemy. Headless guys that suck dick. And slow the game down. Oh my god, what is wrong with your neck? You gotta go see a chiropractor. Or, I don't even know, a carpenter or something. Get that shit sewn on. Note to self, figure out what carpenters do. I don't think it's sewing. Fly over these spikes, which is good, because otherwise I'm probably in a place where I would damage myself on them. Almost take damage against the fly, check. Pick up a lot of money and bombs, check. Find the item room, sadly still no. Hey, that champion dropped the chest. Another bomb and a scent in it. And there's a tinted rock over here, which I probably would have missed if I didn't take a second glance at that enemy. Two more spirit arts. Very useful for me in this position. And the guts should be pretty much destroyed. Some of my favorite enemies to encounter this early on in the game. Dare we fight the boss right away? I think we dare. And we'll use our Devil Tarot card as well. There we go. So now we're doing... huge amount of damage, as you can tell by the fucking size of my bullets. Good lord. Now, just keep firing away at him. I would love to get him into the laser attack that I love so very, very much. There we go. But I don't think I can get him into a second one set. There we go. Fire your laser. Fire your laser! There we go. Did a sizable amount, but couldn't quite get him in the laser shuffle that I like. That's okay. Watch out for these red flies here. He's caught in the cycle again. I don't like... Oh, man, how did I get caught by that? Well, he's dead anyway. And we got an HP up, which I will certainly not reroll because I desperately need it. Satan, what do you got for me this time? Reroll. Poison damage, Brother Bobby. Not worth it. Really, really amazed that I haven't found the parasite yet. Come in here. Oh. Three of these guys, pretty easy to take out. But you do still have to keep your wits about you. I mean, they activate pretty reliably when you walk past them. You gotta kind of set yourself up with a path. I don't need anything out of that chest. All that awaits me in that room is woe. So we'll place bomb here. Looking for the secret room and finding it. Slot machine. We'll just explode that. Hopefully get some money and bombs out of it. Bombs and keys, that's fine too. Actually, I would have liked to get a pill out of it. I haven't really been lazy so far in this video. Haven't had much of an opportunity. Haven't seen any arcades yet. Which means we're likely to come across on this floor, if I had to hazard a guess. Got one bomb fly dead, and two bomb flies dead. That was my impression of the Tootsie Roll Owl from the commercial for Tootsie Pops, which aired probably 45 years ago on TV. Kind of a dated reference, considering I wasn't even born when it started. Alright, let's murder these bombs, murder the last two fistulae. Certain that's incorrect pluralization, but I don't really care. I'm not a doctor who specializes in fistula. HP upgrade, definitely not gonna reroll that. Starting to feel pretty good about my health right now. Looks like I got a huge distended ball sack dripping from my chin. It's beating in time with my heart, it's got its own pulse. I gotta enter the adult film industry. That wasn't related to the ball sack hanging from the chin, I was just giving myself a to-do list for later on in the day after I finish this video. Tons more money there. Couple of zombies. In fact, a trio of zombies. But I have a few advantages of my own, so I don't consider this to be too difficult of a room. Get out of there! You don't have to admire your tarot card for that long. You've seen it a thousand times. Down here. Oh, room full of leapers, but on the bright side, we have a tinted rock as well. I was hoping for spirit hearts, but bombs and keys, oh, they'll do the trick too. Really need to start leveraging my Ouija board more than I am right now. If I could only get two more cents out of this room somehow, I would welcome that dearly, because I could possibly buy something excellent from the shop here. In fact, I got no cents. Well, that's alright, because we're fighting greed anyway. Don't get so close to me. You're making it harder on both of us, greed. Well, I picked up a lot of money here, which means shop on the next floor is going to be worthwhile. And we probably only got one more room left to deal with here. Two more rooms? Come on, it's getting ridiculous. I can't shoot that TNT? There we go. Just took a little bit longer. Sometimes it gets a little bit wonky with the Ouija board. Makes it difficult to put out poop sometimes as well and shoot fires, but oh well. Put out poop? Where are you going to put it? So we're at about the 23-minute mark right here, and we have done pretty well for ourselves. Kind of an unusual run so far, and I actually was doing very, very well up until the Caves Part 2 and the Depths Part 1 here, where I took substantial amounts of damage, but still not doing so badly. I could really use one more item to put me over the top. Clearly not Mom's Knife, because I apparently lose every time I have that in a video. Didn't even notice that the Devil Room was back there until it was too goddamn late. I thought it always disappeared once you left the room once, but okay. Surely the parasite was not in there, right guys? Right? Just I'm nearly in tears here. Please, just placate me. Took some stupid damage on these leapers, but hey. They're leapers. That's what you do against leapers. You take stupid damage. When in Rome. Oh, I'm getting hysterical, okay. Sure we murder all these headless boarsmen in here. Bombs, money, health that I can't use, little Chub, little Chad, I can never remember. This is Chad. This is Chub. There's nothing little about him. You should see his dick! Okay. Two worms, not an issue. I could be planting bombs to make this fight a little bit faster, but I'm not overly concerned about it. Hey, that's an easy way to take him out. Why didn't I think of that earlier? Hide behind these rocks. Single key for that minute and a half of my life that I'll never get back. And another key. And a bomb. Really amassing a pretty good collection of miscellaneous items here. Should I ever have trouble finding the secret room, which, yeah, oftentimes I do. Of course, we can use these bombs and keys on the wound to maybe give us an extra chance at finding some spirit hearts, which are going to be welcome, considering I don't have a whole lot of health right now. Ouija board has actually been pretty good for me so far. Well worth one heart. I don't think Ouija board is such a fickle purchase. I usually don't think it's worth the amount that they're asking for it, whether it's one heart, two hearts, or, you know, etc. spirit hearts. But sometimes you can make it work for you, and one of those times when you can make it work for you, I believe, is when you're, straight into it, is when you're flying, because you really have a greatly increased mobility then. So you can just hide behind some rocks and make it work for you. Got tons of keys, might as well pop this open. Got a lot of money out of that, and some other miscellaneous knickknacks. There's Mom, but we're not going to fight Mom right away. Instead, we're going to do a little bit more scouting, because obviously we want to find the item room. 31 cents, we probably want to find the shop as well. You know, maybe there's an arcade, although I probably won't have much money left over after the shop. Trying to find the secret room, because maybe there will be some kind of unicorn horn in there, even though I don't really want it. Going to stop talking like this, because it's annoying even me. Whoa! Well, I'm going to be bomb rich after this. Sadly, that's sometimes not enough. Alright, no place to hide on this one. That's okay, we'll try to blow up this TNT. Or to at least get him to eat the bomb. Why wouldn't you eat the bomb? Here comes the food airplane, little chub. There we go, shoot the TNT! Shouldn't be this hard to get the Ouija board. I don't want it to go through TNT barrels. Well, I guess he blew it up himself. And, of course, another two bombs. Parts I can't use, which means the item room has to be, like, three rooms down. There's the secret room. 7 cents, you know, that's not so bad for a secret room haul. Could have been worse, could have been 3 cents, could have been greed. Could have been a contender. Single turret. Another easy draw here. Finally! Although this is a pretty shitty draw. Did manage to take out a leaper and a zombie by virtue of my well-placed bomb there. Got another bomb for our troubles. Alright, well, I really don't need the steam sail, but I guess I'll pick it up because I already have it. I guess we'll buy another bomb, and I got 16 cents left over to spend on judgment, hopefully. Forget me now. Oh man, do I really want to redo the depths part 2? I don't think so. Instead, we'll take, yeah, the game kit. That's a pretty good upgrade. And we're abandoning our D6 just because there are no more item rooms. Forget Me Now was an interesting prospect there, but I really did not want to go through the depths part 2 again. That would mean I would have to basically fight Mom twice. Or I could just go to the item room in the shop again, but hey. Running on a tight schedule here. Of course, there's the arcade. Let's use our game kit here. I seem to have memories that the game kit does not work very well against Mom. So we'll just use that, then we'll go back and fight her. Because again, I'm going to be lazy and I'm not going to go to the arcade because that's just in my DNA. Now, if I get hurt during this fight, I can use my hermit card and come back here and pick up some health and then go back in for a second attempt, I suppose. I also have that one up, but really, considering the damage that I'm doing, Mom should be a relatively easy fight here. Well, not easy, but I shouldn't die, let's put it that way. Would love to have some kind of piercing shots right now, but that's just sadly not in the cards, is it? Oh! Walked right into that one, sadly. Okay, just keep focused and continue taking dumb damage like I have been for the last, like, 2 or 3 seconds here. 20% done, I would say. Just keep hammering away at the eye there. Okay, that one much better. Starting to get my wits about me again. He says as he very nearly gets trampled by a high-heeled shoe. Straight right into that one, too. Taking more damage than I would like here on this fight against Mom. Seems like her shoe is actually, like, homing into me. Or homing onto me, I suppose. Sometimes. That was a bad example. I swear, guys. Go back and watch closely. She's nearly dead. We're gonna come out of this alive. On the first try. It's better than I can say about sometimes. But still, losing this much health in the Mom fight little bit out of character for me, considering she's kind of become easy for me in the past couple of videos. There we go. One heart out of it, and an HP upgrade. Now we begin our trip down to the womb. But I don't hold out a ton of hope for this, considering the fact that I'm down on health right now. We'll play the slot machine a few times. Some money. Really, just a single heart would be enough to get me out of here. Oh, and a speed up pill. All right. I can appreciate the usefulness of that. Oh, got our... Don't forget about our Hermit card. Definitely want to go back to the spawn room. Alright. One more play, then you get the old bomb treatment. Sad for you. Well, we got a bomb out of it, and half a heart. That's something. We got Diglett Patrol here. Normally kind of a pain in the ass, especially on a tight layout like this. But because I can fly, I should be able to avoid pretty much everything they throw at me. And also, I can shoot them from behind the rocks. Makes our job a lot easier on this floor. Bombs are key. Pretty much worthless, so we'll just use that right away. Pick up the Hermit. Who knows, that could save me some travel time. Immediately take some dumb damage on this fetus room. Just doing my best circle strafe around here, but I'm traveling too fast. And taking damage just by running into the fetuses, which is... you know, illegal in 51 states. This is a room I don't want any part of right now. Sadly, I've pretty much got to explore every room. Because I absolutely... Whoa. Diglett, why won't you die, man? I absolutely want whatever upgrades this floor holds for me. This guy's gonna be a pain in the ass, you can just tell. Well, maybe not. Maybe I'm talking out of my ass. Yet another pill. Range up. Something. Again, PhD hasn't really been great to me. Was really hoping for some health up pills or full health pills, but oh well. I got some oh well pills. Just murder this guy. Spirit art, very worthwhile. Hopefully coming up to the boss room on this side. Otherwise, I've chosen the wrong direction, and we might finally get rid of this Hermit card as we travel back to the spawn. You're dead, you are also deceased. But you didn't drop anything, so I guess the joke's on me. This should be an easy room. Could use the game kit here, but I don't want to. Instead, let's try to murder our doppelganger there in the corner. Success. There we go, that went fairly well. Extra half heart, which I can absolutely make use of. Skull legs, please. Ooh, death. Death's a tough one. We'll try to hammer away at it and maybe get it out of its first phase here. We succeeded there. We were riding with death for a little bit, but now we got over it. Got the horseman. Or the horse coming after us. In addition, we have to take out death himself. We're gonna go after him first, because then he'll stop spawning the zombies, and also... when the horse is around... oh, I guess we'll murder the horse first, actually, by accident. But when the horse is around, it can murder the zombies for us. Makes our life a little bit easier. Come on! So we got our next cube of meat. For the first time in a while, we got a chewy meat boy. Sadly, no opportunity to trade with the devil. Looks like I won't be getting the parasite this video. I was really holding out hope for it there, too. Meat boy, kinda standing around here. Thank you. You're gonna be very helpful during the fight against Mom's Heart, I'm sure of that. Not as helpful as Brimstone, but bad gas, pretty terrible pill, but it's probably better than my Hermit pill at this point. Just gotta make these guys dizzy as fuck. Oh, the sis, Meat Boy. If ever there was a time for you to shine, this would be it. God damn it! It's like playing Ikaruga! Got only two left. Wow, that actually went pretty well. But this is the wrong direction. This was not the path I'm looking for. Oh god, they got me hemmed in surprisingly, despite the fact that I can literally travel anywhere in the room. Just gotta stay focused, stay focused. Stay on target. Where are you going? Diglett! Stop being such a douchebag! Thank you for the half heart. Oh, I'm back to full health. which means I can't make use of that either. But, coming in this room? Yeah, why not waste a key flying into this? Oh, it won't let us, actually. Tons of money. Arcade, which again, I've just... terribly stupid damage there. Don't really want to visit the arcade. Running on a tight schedule here. Seems like a good room to use the game kit on. We'll probably recharge it once before the fight versus Mom's Heart anyway. And I seem to recall fighting Mom's Heart and being like, why doesn't the game kit work? So maybe it's not so bad if I lose it. A spirit heart there, as well as a tarot card that allows us to fly, so we should probably go back and use our bad gas pill. Done far too much exploration for the reward that we've gotten. Where the heck is the boss room? Maybe it's to the left here. That's my hope. Oh god! No excuse for getting hit in a room like this, because I should be able to outmaneuver the shit out of these guys. Okay, me boy, I will take them down to the ooze state, then you just chew them up. Alright, well, not exactly according to plan, but still, I appreciate it. You get an SMB for effort. Just get this brain... Again, Meat Boy, feel free to not be a latchkey kid. You don't have to just tug at my coattails all the time. Go ahead, get yourself dirty. Not like that, you sickos. Same room we've done 100 times. I just kind of want to skip it. And the easiest way we can do that? Not blowing a hole in the door. Instead, we'll just destroy them. And this is the wrong direction as well. We'll just escape out of the top here. Got a ton of bombs, might as well speed myself up. Oh, this is a terrible room! Get the heck out of here! This room I can deal with. Still, terrible damage, but... Oh, now I gotta use another bomb to get off the other side of the room. Then, of course, that was inevitable. Get out of here. It's gotta be up now. Oh, it was right there the entire time. Okay. Focus. We can't even bomb our way into the boss room from here. So, about to do things the old-fashioned way. Actually, kill things! Sister's nearly dead. Sister's really dead. Tarot card is the Hermit. Bad gas is more effective right now. Game kids recharged. Alright, we're good to go then. So I guess we'll use bad gas on the heart, should we ever get there. Once it comes around. Jesus, these lasers are taking me longer than usual. There we go. Poison damage in on it. Let's use game kid right now. Get rid of these vaginal silkworms. And try to catch Mom's Heart into that bomb state that I love so much. Oh, that was dumb damage for me to take. It's okay. Just hammer away at it. Drop some bombs. Ah, oh, Meat Boy, you're kicking my bombs away, buddy! It's really essential that you don't do that. I'm writing a strongly worded letter suggesting you don't do that. I'm placing my bombs in blah, 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 blah. I can't speak English. Don't kick my bombs, you dickhole! Dude needs to, I don't know, learn how to play soccer or something, or stop learning how to play soccer. Recording this in Canada, we play ice hockey here. Okay, yes, yes, you chew. I'll deal with Monstro. Shouldn't it be Duke of Flies at this point? Oh lord, that was a stupid way to take damage. Thankfully I got that one up so I could, you know, fail miserably again. Alright, that was easy. Here we go. We got it going well now. That thing didn't die. That was Duke of Flies. And I took some more damage? I may actually lose this fight. That would be devastating for me. Oh, Lord. Meat Boy, it's up to you. I'm trapped in the corner here. Oh, I can walk over the creep. I forgot. Or fly over it, I suppose. Okay. Amazingly managed to succeed there. Let's head down to the next floor. Not doing so hot, but again, even if I die right up the bat, which it's looking pretty goddamn likely considering what just happened, I got the one up so I can try it again. Let's not go down this time. plant a bomb, which I don't have very many of. And try to expedite our way into the next room. Nice kick, me boy. For once, that actually worked out well for you. How are we gonna deal with this? God, okay, they blew open a door to the next room, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. I don't wanna be in here either. This room sucks. It's one of the hardest rooms I've ever seen. God, oh, look, this is the end. There's no way around this one. Me boy! Oh, it all came crashing down so fast. Well, it wasn't a great run, but it was reasonably entertaining, I think, and we also did not get the parasite, which means I will see you guys next time with yet another Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. As always, thank you guys for watching.